Yeah, thank you very much. My name is Christoph Birkholz and I'm doing my PhD here at the University of St. Gallen in the field of management of renewable energies. So I look at management solutions for renewable energies in developing countries and at the base of the economic pyramid. And in my essay, I actually asked a question of what are the new entrepreneurs, and so the essay is titled A New Breed of Entrepreneurs, The Emergence of a Global Movement. And it is really about new entrepreneurship in the times of crisis. So we are facing multiple crises in the economic and financial domain, in environmental issues, as well as in the social sector. So new entrepreneurs step up to actually tackle those challenges. First and foremost, it does about social and environmental change, and then it is about financial sustainability and financially viable. And this is not about a niche called social entrepreneurship, but really about gaining momentum. So the idea is those entrepreneurs have always been around. They have always been new entrepreneurs like I describe them, like I understand them. But this time it is different. This time they really become the mainstream of entrepreneurial initiative. And this is also what I experience here at the symposium. So what does it need actually for those new entrepreneurs to emerge on a global scale? And this is the question I'd like to answer in my essay. And I say it needs, of course, networks, and it needs local connection, but as well some global connections, because it is physical meetings where you actually convince other people that you have a good idea and you bring something forward in the social domain or environmental domain. So it is about global and local connectedness. It is about legitimacy. It is about opportunity costs and lowering all those high barriers for entering entrepreneurship in the social domain, not striving for the big jobs at all those large organizations. So it's really about creating legitimacy for this new type of entrepreneurship. And then again, networks and legitimacy are not quite enough. You really need those physical places. You really need a place where you can build your company and connect with people. So I talk about those places, most likely offices, which are a lot about co-sharing and about entrepreneurs who try to scale and replicate their ideas on a global scale as well. So those places are needed, besides those networks and legitimacy. And I say those places emerge, which is the hub global network. And this is pretty much a network of atmospheric places, those magical places where young and old get together, talent and experience to create something which is called social innovation all around the world. So there are 22 hubs already in the world, and another 60 emerging across the globe. So I describe one of these emergence. It is the Hub Zurich, and it's my personal story. And it's really a story which is somehow linked to the symposium as well, because of the four co-founders, three have been here. One of our advisory members has won the award somehow 15 years ago. And well, I'm standing here now to present the co-founding of the Hub Zurich. And as I said, I understand the symposium as well as like a place for those meetings and those discussions and this getting together of, I call it, unlikely allies. This is, again, talent experience. This is politics and economics and business. When those people get together, there's something magical happening. There are new ideas emerging and new projects being started off from the symposium, actually. So what the Hub is somehow creating this atmosphere on a daily basis, just after the symposium, imagine everybody would stay here and continue working on all the ideas that emerged during this event. So that's what I somehow expect here as well. And I so much look forward, and it's a great pleasure to be here. And thank you very much for the organizers, of course. Thank you.